In the shadowy annals of history, we find an eerie tale of King Saul, his desperate bid for guidance, and the Witch of Endor. On the eve of a tragic battle at Mount Gilboa, Saul, cloaked in disguise, sought the counsel of the infamous Witch of Endor. His request? To conjure the spirit of the prophet Samuel from the depths of the netherworld. In the ancient world, necromancy, the practice of summoning the spirits of the dead, was often conducted through ghost pits. Specially sanctified sites where these ethereal voices could be called forth. It's here we find the Witch of Endor, reluctant, yet ultimately agreeing to Saul's plea. Saul's request, however, was not a simple one. He sought a woman possessing a ghost pit. This term, OB or OV, is a Hittite word borrowed by the Jews, signifying a sacred site for necromancy. Ancient texts paint a vivid picture of these ghost pits, the spirits rising from them sounding like chirping birds, reminiscent of the Egyptian depiction of human spirits as birds with human heads. When the Witch of Endor summoned the spirit of Samuel, she was shocked at his appearance. Saul, recognizing Samuel, prostrated himself with his face to the ground. Samuel's words to Saul, "Why have you disturbed me by bringing me up?" echo the forbidden nature of this practice among the Jews. This ancient practice of using ghost pits for necromancy wasn't exclusive to the Jews. The Sumerian-Babylonian tale of Gilgamesh, Enkidu, and the Netherworld, dating back to before 2000 BC, also speaks of the hero Gilgamesh using a ghost pit to summon his friend Enkidu from the Netherworld. Such tales underline the pervasive belief in the power and ritual of the ghost pit in the ancient world.